Hello everyone, thank you for joining us today on our session related to building a website with semantic content models. Me, Andriy Zhitko, Alexey Shapovalov and Gregory Gutman will present it to you. Today we would like to focus on the evolution of publishing models in Tridion, benefits that data publishing will bring to our customers. We will cover possibilities of content modeling on content manager side, as well as how you can define your semantic content models on dynamic experience delivery site. Is it true experience building a website using Tridion sites at the end? So let's talk about evolution of publishing models in Tridion sites. On the top of the diagram, static publishing that is not completely gone, but it's not something that you will see very often. Rendering, or in other words, generation of website content view is happening on content manager using templating, and we are publishing pre-rendered HTML fragments to the broker database, and then these fragments can be requested from the web application using serial. Next evolution step is our DXA dynamic publishing, when we publish data model in DXA R2 JSON format to the broker database. However, we are still using templates to convert XML to JSON data. And on the dynamic experience delivery side, we have a public content API with DXA extension that consumes DXA R2 JSON from broker and produces semantic content models to the web application through the public content API client. And the valid question that you can ask: why do you need templates to produce native data from content manager to dynamic experience delivery? And an answer is in the bottom of the diagram. With the new data publishing, we generate standard data model on content manager side and publish it to the broker database. You don't need to do any templating for this anymore. It can be controlled by your editors or content designers on the schema level. And on the dynamic experience delivery side, you can configure your semantic content models and expose them through the GraphQL endpoint to the web application, where client is an optional thing. Summarizing this evolution, I can say that current publishing architecture with the modular templating and dynamic experience delivery deployer, as well as having blueprinting and version support in content manager for templates, was a good solution for this time. It powered a lot of really cool implementations, but the world has moved on, and website development requires strong dev tools, support such as Git, Jenkins, Octopus Deploy, and so on. There are a lot of JavaScript frameworks with a plenty of ready-to-use, user-friendly controls, where the only thing that you need to do is organize them and add some data to it. And taking all this into account, RWS decided to focus Content Manager on content modeling, productivity tools, and content productivity tools for content creation and intelligence services. And dynamic experience delivery will focus more on content search, content retrieval, and mashups. Data publishing will become the standard way to publish content from content manager to dynamic experience delivery. By this, I would like to hand over to Greg, who will talk about business benefits.
Thanks, Andre. Before we continue, I'd like to take a step back and talk about some of the business benefits of semantic models so you'll be well equipped to engage Tridion business owners on the value of the new modern approach. A concept that has started to gain traction in recent years is the notion of a content hub. Demand has grown to deliver content to a wide variety of channels and devices. Tridion customers use the DXD Content Hub to deliver content to many other destinations other than a public-facing website. We power intranets, portals, kiosks, video displays, television sets, and even the new in-car displays. Having a single, centralized source of truth for content makes supporting these endpoints much easier. One key benefit of the Tridion DXD Content Hub is that it uses GraphQL and JSON as its backbone. That means your developers won't have to invest their time in learning a proprietary technology, and they will be able to get up to speed quickly. In addition, many of the new application frameworks have native JSON support, thereby simplifying the overall solution and increasing development speed. Nationwide, an existing customer decided to embark on a project where they used a hybrid approach to use their existing Tridion implementation as a content hub for some of their new sites. Nationwide was able to launch 20 sites in 25 days. We've also seen other organizations see similar gains. An interesting aspect of the DXD Content Hub is that it allows for the empowerment of users with different skill sets. Increasingly, we're seeing web designers and marketing technologists use the platform without needing an abundance of support from traditional developers. Now let's look at some additional technical benefits for our customers. Semantic content modeling on the delivery side allows you to classify content as a content type to improve your headless capabilities for providing omni-channel experiences. It enables out-of-the-box native support for a content as a service model. It reduces total cost of ownership, hiding the complexity of the content management system, and will allow any developer to work on consuming this data for their application. Decoupling content and delivery application releases shortens the time to market. Publishing also becomes much faster because no rendering is involved. Thank you, and back to you, Andre, who will go through the semantic modeling in detail.
Thank you, Greg. So let's cover content modeling on content manager side. So let's talk how you can control your data on the content manager side. Per each field in the schema, you will have two additional settings, include specific field to the data model, and provide ability to search for specific field. Fields are applicable only for the new semantic content models feature. You can publish the field but not allow users to search for it in case it's some metadata that can be used only on the application side. Or you can exclude this field from the data model, obviously without possibility to search for it, in case this field is required only by content manager side, for example, it's used by event system or workflow. When you're defining a new field, both properties are set to true by default. Schema has general settings to mark it as publishable or indexable. If this schema is used only as metadata schema and content should not be indexed, you can uncheck the settings related to indexing and all your schema fields will be not searchable. If you want to exclude item based on the schema for publishing completely, you can uncheck setting related to publishing. Both settings are applicable for component schema, metadata schema, multimedia schema, and region schema. We have covered content modeling on content manager side, and let's talk about how you can define new semantic content models on dynamic experience delivery. People that are familiar with DXA know that we have content models that are defined in web application. With new data publishing, we can do it in a more elegant way, and customers can define their own semantic content models using GraphQL schema definition language. They can define various types of models using familiar concepts like article, news, blog, and others. And main benefit is that instead of querying specific item, you can instead query your defined data type. As an example, you can query all articles for a specific page without necessity to know what actual components were published. There are various points how semantic models can be used in content delivery. They can be exposed natively in Content API. You can customize types within root queries, and as you can see on the example on the right, there is a custom type post. Also, we introduced the option to have a new root queries. We use standard GraphQL schema language to define semantic models. By default, we search for such schemas under content service config schemas folder. And you also can manage your GraphQL schemas through the add-on service. This has two places where the mapping is defined. In new sites 9.6 release, that will be available later this year, the default mapping with Content Manager schema will be created automatically during publishing. So Content Manager schema will become your framework to define a model that will be published to Dynamic Experience Delivery site and consumed through the GraphQL endpoint. So we have covered content modeling on Content Manager side, as well as how you can define your semantic content models on Dynamics Experience Delivery. And now let's talk about how you can consume the semantic content models. You can easily use any standard GraphQL client like Java.NET or JavaScript to consume them. And custom semantic models that are uploaded with proper annotation are automatically exposed in the GraphQL API documentation. And as I promised, we are going to have a true experience of developing a website using Tridion Sites semantic content models feature. Alexei, over to you.
Yes, so let's start with implementing a simple website which uses semantic models. Let's assume that we have the following technical requirements. Andrey provides me some sketches for the future website. It's quite simple, so it have a header and list of articles. Each article has image, title, and short description. When we click on image, we should open a page with full article content. This one. So first of all, we have to define schemas in the content manager. Let's open it. I've already added the schema article that contains the needed fields. So let's open and look on it. The schema contains the next fields: title, article title, short description. It's a description that will be shown on the list of articles, content. This is full content of article and image of article. Also, we should set properties. It should be published, and it should be indexed on DXD. Also, we should set these properties for default multimedia schema because we are using image components based on it. So it's already set by me. This is also mentioned in documentation. After that, we are creating components based on the schemas. There are no need to create component templates or pages. We will use only component contents. So we have some components with some articles. Also, we can create a bundle that allows us to use general workflow for content. Let's create a new one. We can add some components to that bundle. And we now can publish this bundle. The bundle successfully published. The next step is define semantic models in the content delivery service. I will use the add-on service to deploy additional strong type models and methods. I've already prepared this extension. Let's look on it. The This is Unpacked extension for add-on service. And look on this GraphQL schemas. I've defined two strongly typed models. It's full article and short article. Short article contains the next field title, short description, and image ID. Full article additionally has a content field. A short article contains fewer properties than full articles, and this is, can be used in a different part of application to consume only the data that is needed to, in a particular moment. This is all that we need to start implementing the website, so let's go forward. I choose to create a single page application using React library. So I just use create React app boilerplate and added some libraries. Apollo Boost package containing everything you need to set up Apollo client, React Apollo, view layer integration for React, GraphQL tech necessary for parsing your GraphQL queries, and GraphQL also parses your GraphQL queries. In order to be able to access GraphQL service from our React application, we need to create an instance of Apollo client first. This is done in App.js by adding the following code, where URI is our GraphQL endpoint. Our application will contain the next components. Let's look at the sketch. So it will be a header, a list of articles, short articles, full article, and a shared component article image. So move on. Let's define GraphQL query to get list of articles. I've already prepared some for this demo. Let's open GraphQL editor and look on this query. I've used untyped content for this demo. This query returns a list of components based on schema ID 49. And which exist on Content Manager and were published. So let's move on and open article list component. Article list component is simple functional component for React, and it have some blocks and query component which where we defined exactly query, and it returns it renders article short components, where article short component it's quite simple component which render some text like title, description, and also it render article image component. So let's open article image component, and before it, let's look for query, for querying binary components. This query contains some extra fields which we don't need in this presentation, but it's just for some information. The field which we need is download URL. So we can copy this value and open this image. Yes, so let's use this query and create an article image component. That's all that we need to render list of articles. So let's try to start the application and look. Yes, now we have header and list of components which were published. But now we have only placeholder for article. So let's create a component for view article. I will use get full article methods, which I added to content service using add-on service. So this one. Yes, let's look on it. Get full article method, which returns strongly typed model full article, which contains title, short description, content, and image ID. That's all results. So let's create a component which uses this data. I think that's all. And look at it. Yep, it render the article. Okay, let's add a new article. First of all, we have to create image for this new article. I prepared some additional content. And create article. And select previously uploaded image. As I mentioned before, we don't need to place this component to the page or somewhere. We just publish the content. Successfully published, so we return to our application and just refresh the page. Yes, and now we can see a new article which we added moments ago. So that's all what I would like to show. Return entry.
Thank you, Alexey, for such a great presentation. So summarizing, as a first step to develop a website, you need to define your content structure using a new schema settings. You can publish your content as soon as you are done. There is no need for a templating step anymore. Next step is defining your semantic content models. This is an optional step and you can use data model as it was generated by Content Manager and published to Dynamic Experience Delivery. What you need is to consume content using public content API GraphQL endpoint. Thank you for your time. We'll be available to answer on your questions. Hope you enjoyed our session as well as event itself.